consumers are accelerating to what I'll call a synthetic fatigue. Their life has been surrounded by synthetics. I now want whole foods, raw foods, plant-based foods. And then that moved into beauty, clean beauty, paraben-free beauty, simpler, more natural beauty. That wave just came to fashion and textiles. People were thinking, well, why am I wearing this thing that has these toxic dyes? Now I'm just surrounding my skin with textiles that are synthetic? I don't think so. If I have more synthetics on me, that means there's more synthetics in the sea, the air, and the soil. What we think is to deliver what the consumer wants. I think the consumer wants a conscious lifestyle, a lifestyle that is free of this synthetic fatigue that has dominated 40, 50 years of the material industry. We hope to be one of the risk mitigation solutions. Just kill the demand. Kill why people choose, in this particular case, for performance apparel synthetics. Dr. Haverhals, he invented our technology, this ability to shape and influence the form factor of these natural fibers. His approach was to, instead of, you know, stripping everything down, just massage it, just push it, just reshape it, just get a new form out of it using these chemistries. And therefore, you can retain some of the inherent elegance of these polymers, but get new performance, get new functionality, get new quality out of them. So that was the birth of natural fiber welding, and that's where we get our name, fiber welding. Our platform essentially manipulates those bonding regimes and re-engineers them, recreates them, so we get new shapes. And if you can control the shape of a yarn, you can control its functionality in a fabric. It'll work with any polymer, any material that has these hydrogen bonding regimes. So cotton, the lensing portfolio, viscose, lyocell, and then it also works equally well with the animal protein. The really elegant part about our process is everything is closed loop. So all the chemistry, the water, really everything that we apply, we rinse off and re-recycle. We don't send anything down the drain. We literally recycle everything. And in textiles, that's a big deal because, of course, the water use is a well-known problem, and we basically have none. If you talk to Luke, our CEO, you know, his vision is that fiber welding is so impactful from a performance and so accessible from a unit economic standpoint that mills cannot afford to do anything but fiber weld. Everybody on Earth, by virtue of wearing clothes, has a relationship with textiles. Everybody. And it's a very intimate relationship. And I think it's rare that you can work in such a space. It really impacts everybody on Earth.